Incoming subspace signal.
What was the name of Captain Jonathan Archer's dog? Was it A, Horatio, B, Molly, or C, Porthos? The answer is C, Porthos. Captain Archer often fed him cheese.
Incoming subspace signal.
What does the T in James T. Kirk stand for? Is it A, Thomas, B, Terrible, or C, Tiberius? The answer is C, Tiberius. Kirk was the only Starfleet cadet to ever beat the Kobayashi Maru simulation program.
Incoming subspace signal.
What is the color of Vulcan blood? Is it A, blue, or B, green, or C, yellow? The answer is B, green. Mr. Spock is only half Vulcan. His mother was human.
Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of Star Trek. Its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds.
To seek out new life and new civilizations. To world we go, where no one has gone before.
Aboard the shuttlecraft, let's go over a few important safety instructions. Food and beverages are not allowed on the shuttlecraft. You should not board if you are pregnant, have a heart condition, or suffer from back or neck trouble. You must be at least 42 inches tall. Once you have boarded the shuttlecraft, please move to the farthest seat so you can make room for the people behind you. Show any personal items in front of you. If you are traveling with children, make sure their seatbelt is fastened first. After securing the child's seatbelt, secure your own.
I know you're going to find this hard to believe, but you're now aboard a spacecraft. This is the Federation Starship Enterprise. And you're now about 10 billion miles from Earth. And that's not all. You see, you're no longer in the year 2008 anymore. This is what you would call the future. The year is 2371.
Wait, 2371? I was supposed to have a break in like 5 minutes.
Who's in charge here?
Yes, I am.
Please, step this way. Someone from security will brief you after the transporter officer will take you there.
Everyone else, follow me to the bridge. Quickly, everyone. There's no time to lose. Right this way, everyone. Keep moving and follow me. I'm sure you all have a lot of questions. If you just be patient, we'll explain everything. Don't worry, we're going to do everything we can to get you back to your own century. We're about to board the ship's bridge. For security reasons, we have you stand towards the back. Right this way, everyone. Move in quickly.
This way, following me. We ask that you stay in the center of the gray area on the deck, standing clear of the fore and the aft consoles, as we will need access to them.
Once again, we ask that you stay in the center of the gray area on the deck, standing clear of the fore and the aft consoles, as we will need access to them.
Ensign, contact the shuttle bay and inform Commander Wright that our guests are here.
Aye, sir.
Continue moving all the way in, staying in the center of the gray area on the deck, standing clear of the fore and the aft consoles.
Contact the shuttle bay and inform Commander Riker they're here.
Aye, sir.
Riker to bridge.
Go ahead, sir.
Have we lost the Klingon?
No, sir. They are still in pursuit.
Go to red alert.
Aye, sir. Red alert.
I'm Commander Will Riker of the USS Enterprise. There isn't much time, so I'll get right to the point. You've all been abducted from the 20th century by a hostile group of aliens known as Klingons. Lieutenant Edwards.
Sir?
Give them a look at what's behind us.
Aye, sir. At view on screen.
Those ships are under the command of a Klingon captain named Korath. That's enough, Lieutenant.
Aye, sir.
Korath has located a temporal rift in the space-time continuum and found a way to transport you through it.
Fortunately, Starfleet Intelligence got wind of what he was doing. We managed to intercept you while mid-transport and beam you here.
Korath has nothing against any of you. The man he's after is Jean-Luc Picard, the captain of this vessel. And until a few moments ago, he was sitting in that center chair. But the instant you arrived, the captain disappeared, and we think we know why. Korath's plan was to kidnap an ancestor of Picard so that the captain would never be born. It looks as if one of you must be that ancestor. In order to restore the timeline and get Captain Picard back, we have to get all of you back where you belong.
Sir, the Klingons are powering their weapons.
Open a channel.
Aye, sir. Channel open.
There's no point in running, Enterprise. Give me Picard's ancestor, and the others can return to the past.
Forget it, Korath. These people are under my protection. Every one of them.
Fool! You will regret defying me!
End transmission.
Aye, sir.
We're going to try to lose the Klingons in a nearby nebula. We'll put you aboard a transport shuttle and take you back to the temporal rift, which Korath used to bring you to the future.
I'll lead the way aboard this shuttle, the Valiant.
Ensign Thomas, get those people down to Shuttle Bay 2. I'm heading back to the bridge.
Aye, sir. All right, everyone. You heard the commander. We're going to take this turbo lift down to the Shuttle Bay. Follow me.
We're going to take this turbo lift down to the Shuttle Bay. Follow me.
Thank you.
All the way inside.
The Klingons are coming in behind us.
Hang on, everyone! Lost power. It's 14 for 20.
Cover ship down to 7%.
Hurry! Coming back online. Got it! That was a close call. Is everyone sure they're all right? All right. Are you all right? Is everyone all right here? Just a little rattled.
Listen, everyone, our power is out on this deck. We should have a backup line momentarily. In the meantime, stay together. Follow me right this way, everyone. I need to get you down airlock number one. Right this way, we are in a red alert situation. Right this way, we have arrived. All the way in, please. All the way in.
Before we put you aboard the Goddard, I'm going to show you parts of the standard safety briefing for Starfleet transport shuttles. I'm going to skip ahead to the loading procedure.
Weiya pani denkata.
Sorry, wrong language mode.
And watch your step.
Here we go.
When you enter the cabin, move toward the far side before sitting down. Stow any items you brought aboard under your seat. As soon as you're seated, fasten your safety restraint. Insert the metal plate into the buckle and tighten. If you have children with you, or someone who needs help, make sure to fasten their restraint first. As you know, space travel can be turbulent. So please stay seated until you're told it's all right to stand. If you're prone to motion sickness, dizziness, or seizures, notify a shuttle officer. If you're pregnant, suffer from a heart condition, or have back or neck injuries, you should not board the transport.
We haven't been able to restore power to the deck you're on, so once you're aboard the Goddard, your pilot is going to have to blow out the shuttle bay door. As soon as your ship clears the Enterprise, I'll take the lead aboard the Valiant.
Hang on.
We've got company.
Get them out of there, Geordi. We'll give you cover.
Stay with me, Goddard. I'm setting a course for the rift.
Right behind you, Commander.
We'll keep the Klingons busy, Geordi.
Warp 6 for 3 seconds.
Aye, sir.
Drop down into the rings. I'm gonna scan for the rift.
We're coming in behind a school of Krellian Dyson. Don't worry, they're harmless.
Goddard, there's no sign of the rift, but you'd better get down here. I'm detecting a cloaking device somewhere beneath the planet's surface.
That might not be so easy, Commander.
Just lock onto my impulse wake and fall in behind me.
Hold on.
I could use some help, Goddard.
You've got it. Hang on.
I think we found our cloaking generator.
More Klingons, sir.
I'll draw their fire. You destroy the generator. We need to fire together. Now! There's the rift. Follow me in. Okay, let's get these people back where they belong. They followed us back. Evasive pattern, Beta 2.
I'm with you, Commander. Goddard, Valiant. Valiant, do you read me?
I'm all right. Stay with me. This is the place.
Commander!
Tractor beam, fall off!
Too late.
It's over, humans. But take heart. Today is a good day to die.
If you say so, Korath.
Nice timing, Commander.
We thought you might need a hand, Geordi.
Goddard, are you reading that access shaft?
I've got it. Hang on, everyone. According to our historical logs,
These are the simulators you were about to enter when the Klingons beamed you to the future.
Welcome.
I'm going to set you down right below them.
We hope you enjoy Star.
Captain Picard to Goddard, can your passengers hear me?
Yes, Captain.
Ladies and gentlemen, I owe you all a debt of gratitude for helping restore the timeline, as well as my own existence. But please, don't tell anyone what's happened to you today. It could disrupt the future once again. While only one of you is my ancestor, each of you holds that future in your hands. Guard it well.
This just in, more than 24 people have reported seeing unidentified flying objects in the skies over downtown Las Vegas.
Do we have a live feed? Okay, we're going to Bill Murdoch, live with a News 3 van standing by at Nellis Air Force Base.
No official statement at this time.
But what about the eyewitnesses, Colonel?
We've confirmed that what they saw was just a weather balloon.
But what about the explosions?
Sunspots.
Colonel, please!
We'll be bringing you more on that story as it develops.
Still to come on News 3, Las Vegas has another multi-million dollar slot winner. We'll introduce you to the Happy Millionaire.
That's coming up next on News 3, where news comes first.